Karthikeya, we also have Shakti Sinha. Mr. Shakti Sinha is joining us on the phone line, a former PMO official. Karthikeya, please go ahead.
Thank you, Mr. Sinha, for joining me. Mr. Sinha also served as Joint Secretary to Atal Bihari Vajpayee. He's chairman of the Nehru Memorial Trust today, which is undergoing a complete complete reformation, I would say a sort of a sea change under his tenure. Your first thoughts, sir, about Atal Bihari Vajpayee and when you worked with him?
Karthikeya, of course, he has been suffering for some time in hospital, ICU. So in one sense, though inevitable, when actually it happens, mentally, obviously, you're not prepared for it, you know. So obviously, the first thoughts are, it's bewildering, but it's difficult to express it. But on, yes, as you were just mentioning, this amount of good things being done, the kind of economic reforms. So while people remember the nuclear and the other things, I would remember him mostly, not just like that, a lot for the economics part of it also.
Mr. Sinha, you work very closely with him. How was he different as a person? Can you take us through certain interaction of yours about Atal Bihari Vajpayee, not as a Prime Minister, but Mr. Vajpayee as a person?
One, of course, you know, you have a certain impression of a leader, a big leader. Mr. Vajpayee obviously comes across as a very normal kind of a human being, likes, dislikes, fond of good food, likes to read the papers very thoroughly, jo kida kehte, every word of it, analyzes it, you know. So, personally, of course, he is not very, very quiet person in that sense, not the page 3 social variety type at all, the other end of it. So on one hand, very supportive of his team, very considerate. Like I remember an officer had some difficulty in the family in the sense of wife had some health problems. Immediately he said, let us transfer him out to a good place where the officer's wife can have good treatment. So it was always a human being, a very warm and human being full of heart. So that on the personal side was very, very important. And for people who work so closely, who spend 16 hours a day together, that is really something that you remember a lot.
Mr. Sinha, a lot of things happened during Atal Bihari Vajpayee's tenure. You had Lahore, you had Kargil, the Kandahar hijacking took place, quadrilateral project came up, telecom revolution took place during his tenure, obviously the nuclear architecture was given a shape by him. But what will be his most enduring legacy, Mr. Sinha?
That, I guess, would depend. One, I think, enduring legacy would be he gave India a sense of confidence, tremendous sense of confidence. You know, 91 economic reforms happened, but after 93, it spluttered. And the United States government had probably good intentions, but didn't really could do much. The kind of the telecom thing which opened up, the Kargil war which took place, the Pokhran blast, the way the whole thing was conducted, Y2K happened and India happened to be there. So the impression you got was this was an India, a new India, an India of the 21st century, which would hold its head up in the world. So I think ultimately I would think that would be the legacy that people 20 years, 30 years down the line would remember him.
And before I let go of you, Mr. Sinha, you have spoken about the enduring legacy. Tell me, there are certain aspects of Mr. Vajpayee which are not known. Is it correct to say that, yes, he was old when he became the Prime Minister, but he spawned a new and a different politics? For example, coalition politics came to stay. There was no UPA, but the NDA was born. And he ended up firming up the anti-Congress and anti-regional party axis firmly, which is RSS BJP politics in this country.
I'm on the road just now, so I'm missing some words in between. But yes, one, of course, this was the first non-Congress government, 99 to 2004, which did its full term. 98 government fell in 13 months. Morarji's government fell. VP Singh Chandrasekhar's government fell. The two United Front governments fell. This was a large government with 28 parties or whatever it is. It lasted about 5 years. So that was, I think, a big achievement for the country, that we need not worry too much about stability if people could get along. But I think even here, if you look back, parties did join the coalition, parties in the coalition did leave. even as collision handling was important, it obviously could not be perfect.